smoked pills and now you're in the Scatu Network room. Are y'all ready to have some fun? Just make sure we're taking care of each other out there. Is everyone on stage ready?
Yeah!
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up! Shows. All Philly can do is this. But I believe Philly is one of the best places to play. People know how to dance and have fun. So this next song goes out to the LGBTQIAs in the room. Happy Pride! Too hard. We had to lose power. I want to take this moment to talk about the best of the worst thing. Woo! Give it up for the best of the worst! 10 years ago, they came to my backyard. Our lovely birth girl, Sadie, actually hit me up when I booked the house from my parents' house saying, this band needs somewhere to play. And so, yeah, the best of the worst ended up playing in my backyard. And the only thing I remember from that show is my friend made brownies to sell them, but someone said there was weed in them. There was no weed in the brownies, but the mind is a powerful drug, and everyone out there were very high with those brownies that were definitely... Don't do drugs, because you can probably do drugs by telling yourself you did drugs. Yeah, fuck capitalism. Thank you. It feels fucking incredible to be able to play the ska show in 2022 and the shit sold out. Hell fucking yeah. It's incredible. It's outstanding. I've been putting on ska shows and playing in ska bands for over 10 years now, and I would have never imagined something like this happening at this magnitude so quickly. So thank you to everyone who's in this room. Ska has a really bad rep because people who like to talk shit also never know what the fuck they're talking about. Even when they claim that they have an MBA in punk rock, but who said I don't know. I often get told things like, I'm not actually black because I make ska music. That's actually something I get told like once a month on Twitter. I've gotten canceled for saying the N-word, which is really funny.
So,
yeah, this next song goes out to anyone who's ever been told they're not black enough, they're not brown enough, they're not queer enough. First off, black people created all the goddamn culture in this goddamn country. So, we can do whatever the fuck we want because we created that shit. Second off, there's no correct or monolithic way to be black, to be queer, to be brown, to be any of those things. And if you ever see someone who is black or brown and you think they're acting white, you have a racist mentality because you have a certain picture of how people of color or queer people should be acting. So fuck that bullshit. Call your friends out on it. Yeah. Not exist to your fullest self, which I'm sure a lot of queer people can relate to at one point of their life or another. And it's scary knowing that, like, your family could find out who you really are, and that could cause a lot of pain in your life. So if you have ever been in that situation, or if you're in that situation now, just know that everyone in this room loves you. You have a community, you have family, you're never alone. That's the beautiful thing about this thing we do during the shows and stuff like that, is this is a community and family. We can lift each other up and build each other up. So thank y'all for being here. This goes out to all the queers, the girls, and the gays. I love all of you.
People get built different. We don't need to figure it out. We just need to respect it.
Yeah!
I get the fame. Thank you for never giving up on me. Oh, Jesus. How's everyone doing? Is everyone staying safe out there? I think it should go without saying that we should respect each other's boundaries in space. And let's have fun, but also, if someone is not vibing, then that's going to be their thing. Don't invade other people's boundaries in space or whatever. Just be cool, yeah? And if you see someone not being cool, whether it's in this room or anywhere, tell them to fuck off. Don't help people if they need help. Yeah? Hell yeah. It's not without anyone. Whoever feels like they didn't take the right path in life, it's all because capitalism makes you believe that you're only worth a dollar amount and wants you to rush into lifelong commitments when you're too young to really realize how fucked it is. Fuck that bullshit. Fuck predatory economic systems. There's no right way to live or exist. You are worth more, much, much more than a dollar amount, especially because money is fake. Fuck that shit. If you want to take 10 years to get a degree or not to get a degree at all, or work in a restaurant because you just enjoy serving and doing that shit, that's completely okay. There's no such thing as jobs that have a low skill or low value. Because if we all take 10 days off, this economy would fucking collapse. Because people have more power than the shitty managers and landlords and businesses do. Shows, and it's really, really incredible. I used to work at a venue called the Talent Farm, TTF Forever, baby! It's incredible how music and this scene has created like lifelong friendships, where 10 years later I can be in a random-ass building in Philly and seeing so many friends I've met throughout the years, friends I went to high school with, friends I went to college with, friends I marched drum corps, which probably three people in this room know what that is with. So many friends, and it's incredible to create a space that allows us to just be ourselves and be really kind humans. It's very apparent, especially with this day and age, being on social media and the internet, is that some people really pride themselves in being a fucking asshole. And that's not a new thing, because before the internet, a lot of people did that too. But the internet allows them to be cowards and do it from a distance. So don't be like that. Don't be an asshole for the sake of being an asshole. It's not cool. But you're all at a ska show, so I'm sure you're not that type of person. And whenever those people are being assholes, I just tell all my friends that I love them, because I don't want that energy eating me alive inside. I'd rather just use that energy to people that matter, if that makes sense. So yeah, this goes out to all the incredible people who are incredibly kind. Don't let anybody go, your sparkle.